Hello friends, today we are going to understand oligopoly market structure in economics in detail with different examples. I have covered following points in my video: meaning of oligopoly, characteristics of oligopoly, the prisoner's dilemma in oligopoly market, the kinked demand curve model. So let us start with meaning of oligopoly. The word oligopoly is derived from two Greek words, oligi, meaning few, and polein, meaning to sell. The term oligopoly refers to a small number of producers working either explicitly or implicitly to restrict output and or fix prices in order to achieve above normal market returns. Oligopoly arises when a small number of large firms have all or most of the sales in an industry. For example, with just four companies controlling nearly two-thirds of all domestic flights in the US as of 2021, it has been purported that the airline industry is an oligopoly. These four companies are Delta Airlines, United Airlines Holdings, Southwest Airlines, and American Airlines. Following characteristics of oligopoly market structure I have included in my video. Few firms. Under oligopoly, there are few large firms, although the exact number of firms is undefined. Also, there is severe competition since each firm produces a significant portion of the total output. Examples of oligopolies can be found across major industries like oil and gas, airlines, mass media, automobiles, and telecom. Barriers to entry. Under oligopoly, a firm can earn supernormal profits in the long run as there are barriers to entry like patents, licenses, control over crucial raw materials, etc. These barriers prevent the entry of new firms into the industry. For example, Big Six energy suppliers dominate the UK market with a combined market share of 78% for electricity supply, according to the energy regulator. This is technical barrier to entry in oligopoly market. Non-price competition. Firms try to avoid price competition due to the fear of price wars in oligopoly and hence depend on non-price methods like advertising, after-sales services, warranties, etc. This ensures that firms can influence demand and build brand recognition. Non-price competition is a key strategy in growing number of marketplaces, TaskRabbit, Fiverr, Airbnb, Mechanical Turk, etc., whose sellers offer their service as a product and where the price differences are virtually negligible when compared to other sellers of similar productized services on the same marketplaces. They tend to distinguish themselves in terms of quality, delivery time, that is speed, and customer satisfaction, among other things. Interdependence. Under oligopoly, since a few firms hold a significant share in the total output of the industry, each firm is affected by the price and output decisions of rival firms. Therefore, there's a lot of interdependence among firms in an oligopoly. Hence, a firm takes into account the action and reaction of its competing firms while determining its price and output levels. For example, market for cars in India is dominated by few firms like Maruti, Tata, Hyundai, Ford, Honda, etc. So there's a lot of interdependence among these firms in an oligopoly market. Natures of the product. Under oligopoly, the products of the firms are either homogeneous or differentiated. The computer technology sector shows us the best example of oligopoly. If we dig under computer operating software, two prominent names come up: Apple and Windows. These two players have managed the majority of the market share. Selling costs. Since firms try to avoid price competition and there's a huge interdependence among firms, selling costs are highly important for competing against rival firms for a larger market share. Ford, Chrysler, General Motors, and Toyota have a collective market share of close to 60% in the US, and they avoid price competition. No unique pattern of pricing behavior. Under oligopoly, firms want to act independently and earn maximum profits on one hand and cooperate with rivals to remove uncertainty on the other hand. Depending on their motives, situations in real life can vary, making predicting the pattern of pricing behavior among firms impossible. The firms can compete or collude with other firms, which can lead to different pricing situations. Samsung and Nokia are two big players in the Android smartphones industry, with the former trying to capture the market by keeping the price lenient. Nokia, however, offers Android phones with the same features and almost similar prices. As their products seem visually identical, both the brands have to make sure they offer customers something that the other does not. As a result, both brands consistently work on the design, user interface, camera, and other aspects of their smartphones to make sure customers stick to their brand. Intermediateness of the demand curve. Unlike other market structures under oligopoly, it is not possible to determine the demand curve of a firm. This is because on one hand, there's a huge interdependence among rivals, and on the other hand, there's uncertainty regarding the reaction of the rivals. The rivals can react in different ways when a firm changes its price, and that makes the demand curve indeterminate. Say, for example, Mary and Raj are the only two growers who provide organically grown corn to a local grocery store. They know that if they cooperated and produced less corn, they could raise the price of the corn. But if they work independently, then it will be difficult to determine the demand of individual growers. Now let us understand the prisoner's dilemma in oligopoly market. Game theorists have developed models for these scenarios, which form a sort of prisoner's dilemma. When costs and benefits are balanced so that no firm wants to break from the group, it is considered the Nash equilibrium state for oligopolies. This can be achieved by contractual or market conditions, legal restrictions, or strategic relationships between members of the oligopoly that enable the punishment of cheaters. Consider the case of Coca-Cola versus Pepsi Company, and assume the former is thinking of cutting the price of its iconic soda. If it does so, Pepsi may have no choice but to follow suit for its cola to retain its market share. This may result in a significant drop in profits for both companies. A price drop by either company may thus be construed as defecting, since it breaks an implicit agreement to keep prices high and maximize profits. Thus, if Coca-Cola drops its price but Pepsi continues to keep prices high, the former is defecting, while the latter is cooperating by sticking to the spirit of the implicit agreement. In this scenario, Coca-Cola may win market share and earn incremental profits by selling more colas. Now let us understand the kinked demand curve model. This model suggests that the prices will be fairly stable and there's little incentive for firms to change prices. If they increase the price, then they will lose a large share of the market because they become uncompetitive compared to other firms. Therefore, demand is elastic for price increase. If firms cut price, then they would gain a big increase in market share. However, it is unlikely that the firms will allow this. Therefore, other firms follow suit and cut price as well. Therefore, demand will only increase by a small amount. Therefore, demand is inelastic for a price cut. Therefore, this suggests that prices will be rigid in oligopoly. The diagram suggests that a change in marginal cost still leads to the same price because of the kinked demand curve. Profit maximization occurs where MR is equal to MC at Q1. Example of a kinked demand curve in practice. One possibility is the market for petrol. It is homogeneous and consumers are price sensitive. If one petrol station increased the price, there would be a shift to other petrol stations. However, if one petrol station cuts price, other firms may feel obliged to follow suit and also cut price. Therefore, a price cut would be self-defeating for the first firm. So friends, these are the total points covered in my video. Thank you for watching my video.